Well, my name is Dino Patti Djalal. I'm the founder of the Foreign Policy Community of Indonesia. I do think that ASEAN is trying its best to navigate in the complex relations, even rivalry between the United States and China in Southeast Asia. I think it's very important for ASEAN to maintain its centrality in the affairs of the region. And it's very important for ASEAN to maintain its coherence, not just centrality, in the sense that fellow ASEAN members must prioritize relations among themselves before they prioritize relations with countries outside the region. That is what the ASEAN family is all about. And I think that is the challenge for ASEAN in the future. And I think in order for ASEAN to be central and to be coherent, ASEAN must also be strong at the grassroots. My concern now is ASEAN may be seen as too elitist in the sense that it's a process that is driven by high-level diplomats and politicians and leaders. But if you ask the population within Southeast Asian countries what they know about ASEAN economic community, for example, you get very few who understand what it is. In Indonesia, for example, less than 1% of Indonesians understand what the ASEAN economic community is, right? So that is something that needs to be fixed. My point is, if ASEAN wants to be strong, it has to be strong at the top, at the middle, and also in terms of people to people. This is why ASEAN has to capture public imagination, and only in that sense we can be masters in our own region. And don't forget that the whole ASEAN project is about allowing Southeast Asian countries becoming masters of our own regions in a place, in an area where historically countries outside the region had always dominated and even conquered countries in this region. So let's be smart, let's be agile, let's be adaptive, engage both the United States and China with equal vigor, but more importantly, we have to engage them in a way that makes ASEAN strong in our own backyard. Thank you.